முக்கியமான சிம்டம் மலவாய் வழியாக ரத்தம் கழிவது, மலம் சரியாக
கழிவு. Unfortunately, they did not keep that because, you know, after she got admitted there, we kept very close to this one so that all other patients were diverted into another ICU. And this ICU was more or less completely occupied only by her. Only one out of these four rooms were used. So they removed the footage because they didn't want everyone to be watching.
Okay, thank you. One more question, answer I want to give.
First, please remember, all the documents are there. The documents will be available for you when the court releases and it's sub judice. And the most important thing is today, we are in a very, very important thing which is threatening the country. These NCDs are threatening the country. You have not realized. You know, even the night before, we lost a young doctor in Madurai. You know, this is happening every single day. I told you last night the number of young people who came with an acute MI. The numbers of patients who are coming with cancer is also frightening. But unfortunately, none of them are coming in early stage. This is where you can play a very significant role. Please do that. And as far as the case is concerned, it's separate, it's sub judice. Whatever you need information, we have given you before and we'll continue to be frank. Because it's whatever we are releasing is what is in print. Thank you. But please think, remember, this is a battle that we're going to fight. The government of India also has done several things. Unless you all bring, you know, that awareness in people and early detection, this cancer will still be a death sentence. We want to say cancer is conquerable. There are several steps that we have taken. Today we are so grateful for Cleveland Clinic, UCL and Barcelona Clinic to cooperate and see what more we can do for better management, better outcomes of our patients. So please tell this to people that do not neglect the symptoms and have a routine checkup. I know in some countries it's compulsory. So I hope one day they will make it compulsory that certain age groups must have these tests. And I think that is the intention also of the government of India when they announced all those major programs.
Great pleasure. I'm here to welcome all of you.
As far as dear Amma Avargal, you know, all of us respect it. The institute has done its very best. And we had cooperation from all over the best people in the world. And it's unfortunate that we couldn't save her. And now that it's under the investigations, I wouldn't like to say another word. I think whatever I could say, I've said that she became very critical. We did our very best and then we thought she had good hope and she was recovering fast. I made that bold statement because I was sure. But unfortunately, she had this sudden massive heart attack. From even for that they tried their very best and we could not, so we are sorry. Now let's contain, you know, whatever the subject is. I think we should not talk more because very clearly we are given. I'm sure they have asked our people, the committee, say one man commission is going to ask that. We have given all our records, so we'll know secrecy about it because I think it is not one day or two days treatment. It was a major illness for several days and weeks. Everybody did their very best from my ward boys to the technologists, to the doctors and the nurses, they did their very best.
யார் யாரெல்லாம் சந்திச்சாங்கன்றதும் அதில் தெரிவிச்சிருக்கீங்களா சார்?
I'm sorry, you know, in hospital what we follow is a very simple policy. As far as possible in intensive care unit, we don't allow anyone except close relatives and for a short time. Since she was very critical, we did not permit, but the relatives have an option to ask for some people for which the doctor who is on duty allows them. I don't know, I was not a training doctor, but I know the team of doctors of all our hospitals cooperated in this, and even the doctors from other countries were here. They came the best possible treatment. This is how we had high hopes that she was recovering well. And I almost said she is well. And that's how she appeared. And we moved her from the intensive care to an ordinary room because of her improvement. I don't know. Dr. Bama, any? Has I called any of you? And you know, whatever it is, we are, as I said, we have submitted all the reports. Whenever we call, all of them are ready to appear. Day to day, I don't follow this up. All the every single document that from the time of our arrival, and also they have given the previous treatment of the late Chief Minister to the Commission.
You are asking from the Inquiry Commission affidavit. You have received that document's copy?
No, we have submitted it to them. They are keeping them with them. I'm sure they will return when their work is done.